A very good morning to all my dear students. As you all know that we are doing a third chapter, the Rocking Horse Winner. So that chapter is so much lengthy, so I just decided to do it with pics. So it's easier for you to understand the story of the chapter. So from starting, I will start it so that it's clear with all of you. There is a beautiful woman named Hester. She's very beautiful and everyone thought that she's very happy in her life, but actually she is not happy. She is a greedy woman. She just want more and more money. So many things troubled her because she wants money. And even her three children would feel the hunger for money. They always listen the voices on their house which are chanting. What are the voices? More money. There must be more money. There must be more money. Nothing would ever seem right in this house. When the children play with their toys, there must be more money, there must be more money. Such type of voices are there. One day, the child asked her mother that why they owned their own car, like uncle. Then the boy asked his mother that Uncle Oscar always talk about filthy luck, that it is filth luck. Then his mom told him that no, it does not mean good luck. It does not mean the same. But she also told him that luck is important in life. Luck is an essential to become successful. If you are having a good luck, then you are having money. If you are not having a good luck, then you are not having money. The reason why their family was so poor was that both the father and the mother had low income jobs, and the only way to become succeed was to have luck. She had married Paul's father for love, but the love had turned out to be dust. When she realized her husband was unlucky, Paul then claimed that he is a lucky person. So now his mother told him that his father is an unlucky man, that's why they are not having so much enough money at home. But Paul says that he is a lucky person. His mother did not believe her. Actually, she replied her in a very sarcastic way, in a very anger, we can say that, like a comment. But the boys won't too, that his mother takes his words seriously. So what he do? He went to his room and start playing on his wooden rocking horse and rocked away vigorously, seeking the true meaning of luck. He want to find out the true meaning of luck. He believed that if he rode the horse hard enough, it would take him to the luck. His mother watching over him as he rocks on his horse. She also feel worried because she's overly concerned about Paul's well-being. Knowing that she internalized her children's thoughts and judgment. Meanwhile, Paul's uncle, Oscar Croswell, encouraged Paul to continue pursuing his dream for this luck. So his mother is also worried about Paul, and then Uncle Croswell, Oscar Croswell, also arrived there. That's right, son, don't stop until you get there. Paul was riding on horse that time, and I'll also say that till the time you don't get your luck, just go away. What is the horse name? Asked Uncle Oscar. Just one, not any name. Firstly, he said that he had several names. Just last week it was Sansovino. It had turned out that Bassett, a young gardener, has been talking to Paul about horse racing. So now uncle was surprised that how the boy know about the horses, name of the horses. So the Paul told him that the Bassett gardener always talk with me about the horses. So name of the winning horse last week is Sansovino. It also turned out that Bassett had been secret partners in business with Paul. They were able to rake in large amount of money by betting on horses. Paul and Bassett decide to let Oscar in on the secret partnership since they believed he could be lucky as well. After all, it was the first 10 shillings given by Uncle Oscar which he had won the race. So now they believe that uncle was lucky for them. So what happened till now? Bestie and Paul think that uncle has given them 10 shillings and they bet for that 10 shillings and they won. So they believe that uncle Oscar is lucky for them. So they also want their uncle Oscar to be their partner. Then Oscar Bassett played along with Paul as they both did not believe his claims. So they let him decide which horse to be bet on. This week he was sure that Daffodil was to bring home the gold. Now time for next betting. Now Uncle Oscar is also with them. Now they are asking that which horse will win this week. So the child Paul says that this time Daffodil will win. Oscar tried to convince Paul to choose a different horse, one that was so slow, but Paul insisted that Daffodil was going to win the race. So Oscar placed Paul's share of bets on that horse. Of course, Daffodil ended up winning. So Paul put 300 amount on the horse and the bestie put 150, but the uncle put only 5. At last, Daffodil wins horse race. Oscar asked Paul what his motives were. Paul explained that I started it for my mother, that I was having all the money for my mother. She said she had no luck because father is unlucky. So I thought if I was lucky, it might stop whispering. Okay, now the child horse has win. So he put 300 on the horse and it is the 4 time more the betting. So now he get 1200. So he won 1200 pounds for that betting. So he's having enough money. So Uncle Oscar just asking that why are you doing all things. He just told him that for my mother I am doing, that it will stop all the whisperings at her house. Her house, I hate her house for whisperings. Paul went on and filled his horse racing buddies in and all the details, including his fear that his mother would stop him if she find out about the betting on the horse. And so the three made an agreement that now they would not tell anyone that Paul is betting on the horses. Now uncle is also with them. So what he has to do with the money that he won? Again he bet on a horse and that time they also won. So this time they get 10 times more the betting amount. So now Paul is having 5,000 rupees, 5,000 pounds. So Uncle Oscar is just asking that what will you do with the money. He says that I will give all the money to my mother as a birthday gift. Every year she will get 1,000. So with the help of the Oscar uncle, they just write down a letter to her mother that any of the relative is just gifting him the 1,000 rupees for on her each birthday, which were to be collected on every year. But mother want to receive all the amount in once. Upon receiving the 5,000 pounds, Paul's mother spent it on extravagant home decor and expensive tutor. With all the sudden costly changes within the house, the whispers in the wall grow louder and louder, saying there must be more money. But still now the whisperings are becoming more louder, that more money, more money. The voices grew louder and even more demanding, and Paul become more and more restless. Now he start betting again. Hester notices Paul's sudden tense and unusual behavior, and with that his mother also become increasingly anxious. So his mother is also in tension that why my son is so much worried every time. Deep inside, Hester knows that her son is terribly ill. She knows about the illness of her child. 2 days before the Derby, When Hester is attending a night party, she suddenly becomes tremendously worried for Paul and give a call to Miss Wilmot. Wilmot is the nurse of that house who take care of the children whenever Hester went out for the parties. And one evening, she is very worried about Paul. She just call Wilmot that how is Paul. Wilmot told her that he was in his room. Okay. And Hester asked that is he okay? All the children are all right. Wilmot says okay. After that, when he asked about Paul, he says that he went to bed as right as a trivet. Shall I run up and look at him? Then Hester say no, don't trouble, it's all right. Hester hangs up the phone. She still holds a feeling of uneasiness. Hester still had the gut feeling that Paul was very ill. So she crept up the long staircase to her son's bedroom. Her fingertips were trembling as he was opening the door. Finally, she opened the doors and she was surprised to see that as she turned the lights on to find her son madly surging on the same wooden rocking horse. That at night also he was just sitting on the horse and riding on that a wooden horse in his room. And what she said, Paul, whatever are you doing? He is just crying. Malabar, Malabar, Bassett, Bassett, I know it's Malabar, screamed Paul. What does he mean by Malabar? Asked Hester. His father also don't know. So nothing seemed to prove a proper remedy for his sickness. On the third day, he became ill. Paul is now on bed. Actually, he just when he sit on the wooden horse, it was according to Beste that there was some prediction to him that this horse will win. So he make a prediction while sitting on the horse and that prediction become true every time. So many times he bet on horses and every time its prediction come true when he ride on the horse, on the wooden horse, and some heavenly powers told him about the winner horse. It is just said by the bestie that Paul know everything, that who will win. But now he is shouting Malabar, Malabar. But actually he fall ill due to tension, due to worriness, and he is on bed. Then bestie visit Paul. Master Paul, Malabar came first. You have made us 70,000 pounds. Now at last, Malabar wins and they got 70,000 pounds. And with that, Master Paul sprung back to life. Malabar, Malabar, did I say Malabar, mother? I never told you, mother. Then the boy told her mother about whole things that if I can ride my horse and get there, then I am absolutely sure. Oh, absolutely, mother, did ever I tell you I am lucky? No, you never did, Hester replied. But that night, Paul passed away. He is died because he was just restless, reckless, we can say that. Because he just want more and more money for his mother. And that day, the boy passed away and he won 70,000 pounds on betting. During the length of the story, Paul's gifts were exploited for money, which was quickly squandered on secular goods by his family. Even after his death, Oscar make an unhelpful attempt to comfort his sister, saying, my goodness, Hester, you are more than 70,000 to the good and a poor devil of the son to the bad. Now, Uncle Oscar is giving comfort to his sister that you are having 70,000 pounds. As this dark and cryptic story comes to an end, readers are reminded to always be grateful for what things you already have without having greed of power, without having power of greed. So this is the story that how a child,
how a boy and how all the members of that house become more and more greedy. They just want the money, more money. For that, what they do? The boy do the betting day and night. He's just thinking about the horses, that which horse was win. He just make predictions for that. He always sit on his horse and it leads to his death. At last he won the money, but he lost his life. So this is the end of this story. I think now it's clear with all of you. Thank you and have a nice day.